Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Thanks for joining me for today's video on lip filler tenting, or I call the pillar technique. We've done it for many, many years. There's a little resurgence of it in the past couple years. So we're gonna go look at the traditional method, a little bit of 3D, and into the pillar method and why, when, and how you may use it. Thanks for joining me today. Let's get right to the video. So lip fillers are somewhat controversial, but they're common for practices because you can use $500 to $800 worth of filler, you see a result, the lip gets attention, it's attractive, the red lips look good, you hydrate, it looks youthful in the appropriate circumstance. Very important to go back and watch my video on lip artistry, because what we're doing when we fill the lip, of course, it's the angles, the folds, the loose skin, the chin projection, the nose, that's to me all part of the lip filler. A rejuvenated face, then a lip. In those over the age of 35 and above, younger people, of course, skin looks good, the fat pads are intact typically, and we can go right to the lip. It's like a designer look. But go to the lip filling artistry video and you can kind of get an idea of why we might use different techniques, because as you're injecting, and this is what makes your injector unique, this is why you go to who you go and why you like the results. As they're filling, they're trying to get a result, and they look and they go, oh, I didn't quite get the projection I want. One side of the lip, the right or the left, is going to feel different than the other, and they might have to go to special tricks and techniques. And then they might look at it and go, I don't quite like the look of that. What am I missing? Ah, the Cupid's bow. Oh, there's smoker's lines or vertical lip lines. That's not gonna look good. We better address those. Do we do it with a cannula? Do we do it with a needle? So that's where the pillar technique comes in. It's a tool to give you that tenting look and to give a little bolus or strip of product to give a lip flip. It does all of those things, but every lip's gonna be a little different. Let's look at a 3D image of a before and after. You can see here in the after on your right, that the patient has swelling. And that will come down and that will occur with whatever technique you do. It depends on the person, what they're on, what they're eating and drinking afterwards, what aspirin or meds they could be taking, the technique, the number of pokes. Really a lip filler, the process itself should take about 8 to 12 minutes. Beyond that, if you're getting so many pokes, you're gonna get swelling. If there's a lot of massaging after, or you're using a product that's meant to draw water in, again, you're gonna get more swelling. If we go and look at a traditional technique, what does that mean? That means first injecting the wet dry along the body of the lip, seeing what projections we get, making the shape, the top versus the bottom. I did a video on the 50-50 lip, but a traditional shape would be the top lip slightly smaller than the bottom lip, and projection is so important because a youthful lip has a nice ski jump, not a duck, but a nice ski jump. And so that's important. How do you get that? And we go and we do the vermilion border, and then there's a whole video I did on the Cupid's bow. Very important not to overdo. Some people shouldn't have it, other people should. Now let's look at the pillar or tenting technique. If we look at the video here, we use a vibration device, and of course we're not touching inside the mouth with our gloves, but we're coming above, we backfill a BD syringe, 31 gauge or even smaller. Most products will push through this. You wanna be superficial. Why? The artery, the superior labial artery, in this case, we're doing the upper lip, most of the times it's at the mucosal surface, kind of behind the muscle. And you'll see people post these videos, oh my gosh, look, I can see the pulsating vessel. I'm not going to inject this person. Think about that. You now know where it is. Those are the people, send them to me. I want to inject them when I know where the vessels are. Of course, there's aberrancy. Sometimes the vessel is in the muscle. So this is a more superficial injection technique, and you're creating these pillars to get a nice look. It's a very very fine needle, so patients tolerate it very well. There are more needle sticks a lot of times than if using the traditional needle technique. Some people like to use a cannula technique, and you can look at my videos on that. Here I'm getting close to the Cupid's bow, and we may fill the filter columns, we may not. Filling out here laterally lifts the edge of the mouth. So if the patient's feeling like, hey, the mouth is turning down at the edge, I put an extra strip down here. You can see that just curled the lateral edge up. It's a nice look. You don't want it to be too upturned. But again, now look, I'm going back and I'm saying, oh, you know what? I want to put a little more medially. It does hurt here. Why do I come back here? Because there's anesthetic in here. And so I can go do one injection, let that work, and then come back. You can always tell if the patient's having pain by they flinch their eye. This patient seems to be doing fine. And now we just go to the other side. And here it's a little harder, of course. You have to match what you just did. And you fill the upper this way. You can certainly then go to the bottom and do a traditional technique at the wet dry border. You don't have to do the whole lip in this method. And you can combine them all to get exactly the look that you want. And this is simply another tool in your toolbox. If your injector doesn't do this method, that's totally fine. It's just sometimes you may need to go to that to get the look that you want. One of the most important things to getting the look you want is communication. It's communication with your provider. It's good if they don't use only one product, because you need a breadth of products to get the result you want. An older lip might just want a softer result. You can see here, if you're injecting for vertical lip lines, you can still backfill that BD syringe, but you might choose a slightly different, lighter product or a more structural product that has a fine molecule size or that's flexible. So the choice of product really makes a difference, and your injector should tell you what they think after taking your history would be the best product for you. So lip fillers, that's the tenting technique or the pillar technique. Tell me, what techniques do you like? Do you like your lip fillers? Go to my video on lip filler lumps and bumps, and you can see that to give you an idea of what are some of the side effects that you can get from lip filler. It's not always all perfect. Subscribe here. Click like if you like the video. Join me on Instagram. We have a lot more before and afters and engaging kind of talk and banter over there. And keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.